Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Beingmamal. I am so exceptionally excited and hyped right now because I have finally found something that this channel can review again, which is actually the original and initial reason why I reactivated this channel to review movies, TV series, music videos, and everything that's, you know, that's worth reviewing. So yeah, it's initially a review channel, but then I rethink again that reviews and reactions are kind of in the same route, right? It's just my way maybe to kind of compensate what I've done to my own channel, right? Okay, so why I'm so excited, because I just finished watching the Apple Plus miniseries called Defending Jacob. I'm inviting you right now to discuss about that very series with me. For you who haven't known that this series is based on William Lane's novel with the same name, Defending Jacob, which I also read. Usually, I'm not really into something like this. So for example, like the movie that is based on a book, which I already read, sometimes I don't really check out the movie or the other way around. Okay, so just like one version of adaptation and that would be all. But this time, I'm going to tell you why this is exceptional, because as I wanted to read the book, so that time I was in the mood of reading crime novel, and then I was looking for some recommendation from Goodreads. I got some, one of which was Defending Jacob. Like, I think I was in the first two or three chapters, I found out about the project, the miniseries project from Apple Plus with Chris Evans, Michelle Dockery, and Jaeden Martell as the main stars. I mean, I was in the first two, three chapters, right? So the case was already like started. So I was already like tied by the book. And of course I would want to finish the book. But I couldn't help it that the announced cast had replaced all of the visualization of all of the characters from the book in my head. So all of a sudden, like, Andy Barber is Chris Evans, and then Laurie Barber is Michelle Dockery, and of course Jacob is Jaeden Martell. I just like it. I continued with those faces while reading the book. But why I continue watching the series as well? That's like really redundant. And then is in a very, you know, short time after finishing the book, the series released, and I watched it. That's because I want to validate, reevaluate, and kind of like compare the visualization that they made me have in my mind throughout reading the book with their version. That's basically the reason why at first. Now let's start from the premise first. So the story centers on the investigation of a murder case of the local boy named Ben Rifkin, who is found stabbed to death in a park, and the town's assistant district attorney, Andy Barber, which is played by Chris Evans, is assigned for the case. And so everyone in the town is actually counting on him, especially the victim's parents. But what starts as cut and dry, very procedural type of case, which is really he's really good at, turns out to be something very personal when everything, all of the evidence is leading to his very own son, Jacob, who happens to be the victim's classmate. So it's really up to him and his wife, Lori, to protect their son from the firestorm that is obviously coming, right? While secretly and gradually throughout the story, having this doubt whether or not the son could actually be capable of doing the unthinkable. So there. So yeah, here. I'm stopping here. I'm not spoiling the story, not intentionally, but there might be some part as I say my take on the story, my take on the case, my take on the series itself. There might be some part that kind of will maybe change your mind about it and kind of spoil the story. But again, not intentionally, you've been warned. If you haven't watched it, if you want to be like free from all of the spoiler, even the tiny bit, please stop watching this video right now. But for some of you who want to continue, let's go. So did you see that premise, right? Especially for Andy Barber, who's usually in this side where he is the one who prosecute the defendant. He's the one with the job to prove the defendant guilty, is now in the other side. That must be a life-flipping, very life-changing experience for not only for him, but of course for the whole family, right? I mean, you know your child, you raise them, you feed them, you talk to them every day, you meet them every day, so you believe your child is innocent, or you want to believe that they are innocent. right? Of course. But then you are human. You must be carried away by everything, the news, the evidence, and then with everything it takes, you must have that slight doubt whether it's about the way you raise them, even like your family history, that now you think it might affect what is happening right now. And I'm sorry for being so unorganized. I'm sorry for being jumpy. But now I would like to talk about the cast. And let's start from Jaeden Martell. I think this one, him playing Jacob, is the best performance he's ever done in his career that I know. He does a very great job in portraying the teenager who's so hard to read. For me, so far, Jacob is one of the most difficult characters to read. He's so unpredictable. We don't know what's inside his mind, what he's actually been thinking all this time, and when he might snap. And despite all of that, Jaeden is able to make us feel sympathy for the character. He's humanizing that character that we actually want to defend him as well. Right? I mean, like, for what he's going through, he has that scared, frightened look, and innocent at the same time. He's amazing actually in here. So I'm giving him that. And as for Chris Evans, I love when Chris is taking a project like this, the one that is showcasing his talent in playing the character that is more complex. Obviously, Andy Barber is a more complex, is a more layered type of character compared to Shmuptown Shmerica, the one that people know him for. I love it. He nails it. And the fact that he's from Massachusetts, it looks like this project is kind of personal to him. And Michelle Dockery, as a mom who believes in son, who raises the son, who feeds the son every day, having to know the fact that the son might have the ability to cause this tragedy is amazing. The helpless, as well as the hopeful look, the stressed, and the disbelief, all of that burden she's having is actually vividly shown throughout her acting capability. That's really amazing that everyone really contributes well to the story. That's what makes the story strong, evenly aced from the first episode to the finale. That's one score. And my respect towards the miniseries has escalated when I found out that it is very faithful to the main source, to the book, in depicting especially the character of Lori and Andy. I mean, what they are going through is the same. Right? What one goes through is as hard as the other, but their attitude, their kind of like take on the ship is slightly different. Let's talk about Lori first. Well, I mean, Lori is the mom. A mom knows her child, right? Like, she loves Jacob no matter what. But then what's great about Lori is that, I mean, I love that she's very rational. I mean, she's very sane. She can see things as what it is. So she knows Jacob, like, since he was a baby, toddler, and kids, and adolescents, until now. So she sees how Jacob is with other kids, how Jacob is when he is having tantrum, how Jacob is when he's upset. So she knows all of that. So she rationalizes that. So that kind of what makes her question the truth about Jacob, question her own belief towards her son. While Andy Barber, the husband, like, his job from the beginning is to defend his son. His love is so unconditional. Whether or not he's guilty, he will just like love Jacob. I mean, that's how the book gets the title, right? Defending Jacob. It's all about defending him no matter what. Him, from all of those people, could have been the one who actually can rationalize that, who can see things as what it is, as it has dealt with a lot of them, with a lot of the cases like this, right? But then he chose not to. But there is one point where he finally like breaks. So that's the moment when he rationalizes everything, just like Lori always does. But the son he loves so much might be guilty. It was kind of hard to watch that. I mean, Andy is the man who lies to protect his loved ones. Right? He's the man with guard, with the walls, with the shield. I mean, at the end of the day, he's always a Shmuptown Shmerica. So to see him breaks his wall finally, it's heartbreaking. So yeah, I said that I love it, that it's so faithful to the main source. But what's more amazing about that is that the creator, decided to actually change a tiny bit of the end, which for me, in my opinion, have done great impact to the story as a whole. So here I'm talking about the series finale, episode 8. It, as it should be, is the most emotional episode of all. It's the most devastating and the most powerful one. I mean, it's so great that it kind of perfects all of the holes that the previous episodes has made. Like, if you find some kind of like nitpick, some kind of like, what is that? In some episode on the seventh episode before, I mean, you know what I mean. This episode comes to mend it, and wrap it beautifully. I mean, the story is more than that traditional whodunit mystery. It's more than that. It's layered, it's painful, it's ambiguous, it's devastating, but you will love the pain. That's it. You will love the pain. You don't need that concrete answer at the end of the day. You don't need the black and white answer, the truth. You don't need that. It doesn't matter. At the end, from the decision that the creator has made, now the barbers will continue the life where they have to relearn, reassess each other. They have to rebuild that trust again, which is gonna be a great challenge for each of them. And especially for Jacob, now he will see the mother differently. The way that she's actually been going through in assessing Jacob, in believing Jacob. And now all of that is his in return, if you know what I mean. So if you have watched that, I think you will understand what I mean. But if you haven't seen that, you will want to prove what's actually going on into that family. What's actually going on in Newton, Massachusetts. So all in all, I love both decisions. The book has that closure where made you kind of like relieved. At least that one problem on what's going on is kind of like closed. And then they need to carry on with the rest of it. But the series has decided to make it more complicated, more complex, more devastating if you think about it again. It's just, it's all dysfunctional. It's all, they're gonna have to relearn, restudy, rebuilt everything from the scratch again, which both left me wow. And that just got me realize that how one turn of event can just flip your life just like that. So you guys, I highly recommend you to watch the series. It's only 8 episodes, so you can just like finish it in a week or like in few days even, or in one day if you want to go crazy. So yeah, and please, from there, please come back to this video and share your comments. And for you who have seen it, you will know what I'm talking about. I would appreciate for us to have these great discussions even after this video on the comment sections. So thank you guys so much for going through this with me. Again, see you in the next video. Until then, take care.